the video games and you can't get any broadband. Got milk? Got milk ain't got shit on my hell. There is no God. Fucking case in point. Do I need to make another case in point? I have to poop every fucking day. Nobody designs you to do that. It's the most retarded thing I've ever
Kim
fucking heard.
Kim Jong-un does not poop every day. Actually, doesn't poop at all.
There we go.
Right? Right? Yeah, I watched a documentary or two about North Korea, and I know somebody...
Son of a bitch, man.
...social media that lives in South Korea.
I don't want that kill. I don't want that kill.
Huh? Oh. Can y'all just, like, chill the fuck out for, like, 3 seconds?
Man.
Jesus. You're like, just stay in one spot for just a second so I can kill you.
No, everyone's, like, on my ass right now. I don't like it. Like,
it's an acquired taste. But yeah, again.
Well, I mean, this ain't the shooting. This ain't the existing Fireman 8. So, you know.
Big.
Wow, that was awful. Wasn't even paying attention. I was just having fun going all diarrhea of the mic. That's what happens when I've been awake a really long time, and then I turn all this like debauchery into a highlight reel and I put it on Twitch. It's labeled mature. Show your grandmother.
Ah, so you like mold.
I actually do like fungus. I like mushrooms, like studying them, identifying them.
Do you like the tips of the mushrooms?
I like my mushroom tip because I don't really have a choice. Nobody else does though. It's fucking ugly. Alien slug tree stump looking thing. Fucking get all turned on, all it does is fucking drool. Look at you sideways. I don't even know where this shit comes from half the time. It's like support for like the argument of determinism versus free will. I don't control the shit that comes out of my mouth. I didn't think that up. That's just a thought that happened. Why it happened, well, that's a fucking complicated fucking story. We had lecturing here for days to explain that one. But it isn't me that did it. You think about that. Everything we've ever learned is why we can think what we think. And so everything we've ever learned is the thoughts of life forms that existed before us. That's why consciousness is a wave. So we're just passing this torch of thought. And every now and then we tack on one little emergent phenomena, some original tidbit that was never thought of before. But it wasn't because we're original and creative. It was because all thought before us allowed us to think this new thought that amazed us. And it wasn't even yours. It was everyone's. It was all thought is everyone's.
Thanks, yep, Confucius. Right.
I just went from raping your grandmother with dead babies and shit, dogs chewing on my testicles.
To that fucking vegetable named Stephen Hawking.
Right, that's right. Like, I mean, you guys did just see how I fucking crushed that philosophy. Like, philosophy of science right there. Like, that's a fact. Like, you're not going to find very many scientists that are going to argue with me about that. At the least, they'll be like, well, I don't know if that's true, but it's probably true.
Oh, heat wave.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And I know it's true. 150% positive, that philosophical bit. So yeah, that's winning right there. So I challenge Stephen Hawking to a thinking competition. Not a math competition, a thinking competition.
Wait, I think one of you guys said it before. If Stephen Hawking wasn't really, like, focusing on, you know, black holes and space and theory of relativity and shit, and actually, you know, I don't know, focused on ALS research, he'd probably find the cure already.
No, he's a glorified math specialist.
There we go.
He's a calculator. Sit down. He's a calculator.
Oh shit.
He's not an abstract puzzle. Yeah, but here's the thing. I'm gonna challenge him to a porno competition. Because I know I can beat him at that.
Well, I mean, but he can't get it up anyways, so...
Actually, I've set you up. I've set this whole thing up. So, funny fact that really the only thing that does work on Stephen Hawking was his dick. And so this is what I say. Like, if I challenged him to a porno competition, I probably would have lost because... You know how someone goes blind and then their hearing gets really badass? Well, he lost everything and all he had was his dick. He's probably fucking, when nobody's looking around his house, he's pogo dicking around the room. Fucking, he's probably, he's got like a line of pornos, and he's like in a gimp suit, all fucking limp dick body with this fucking goddamn pile driver. And he's like jackhammering porn into bitches. It's the most ridiculous thing ever. He's like, your dick's pathetic.
Yeah, get the, yeah. Or like, does not compute.
No, like, he's actually, even though it's hard for him to communicate and all that shit, what he can do is pretty amazing. Thank you, technology. And he's pretty funny. Unless, like, it's all staged, everything, like, someone's telling him what to say or whatever, like, I have no idea. Wish I could talk to him, really.
Right, staged by Illuminati.
Well, like, a lot of things on media or, you know, again, like, thoughts aren't ours. So, like, when you ask Stephen Hawking a question that he doesn't know how to answer, he's just going to look for a memory of something he heard. So you ask him about what he thinks it'll be like when we meet alien life for the first time. And he says that the aliens are going to treat us like we treated the Indians. And that's just an answer that a whole bunch, I don't know who came up with it first, but it's like a really common answer in the scientific community. It's a known answer. And,
what? Are you not dead?
I mean,
get back here.
I don't want to be a Debbie Downer or anything, but those smallpox blankets actually were pretty cool. The smallpox was a little eh, but, you know. The designs they have fucking cool, dude.
It is what it is.
So yeah, good casinos out
not
of it.
Not bad or good. It just happened. So it just is what it is. Like, now we gotta deal with what is. Like, we didn't do it. Like, our forms, if you want to separate and be an individual, we didn't do it. It's not our fault. And I don't care what anyone says. If I'd been back in any history, I would never participate in any of these. I probably would lie and say that I was a very devout religious man that believed in Jesus and loved God and everybody was good, my son, and I'd fucking fake everybody out into thinking I was a priest and fuck everybody's wife and get away with it. In like this world, I can actually be like, nah, fuck you, you're fake, your religion's garbage, I'm not playing your pretend time nonsense, I'm still fucking your wife. Please don't kill me, though. I'm a good guy, I mean it. Everything I say...
Well, at least with one, you're being honest.
I'm a truth troll. I am. I tell people the truth when I know it'll piss them off, but I really am not, because I don't intend to piss them off. I don't get off on pissing them off. It just, it's
just
inevitable.
So dirty.
What do you do about it?
Fuck. 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 Fuck yes.
Pull the trigger.
Here, make this.
Yeah, that was fucking... That was tight right there. Like, and I don't even mean tight, like, slang. I mean, it was tight. Like, the whole thing was tight. Every last little interaction, it was like, I just barely missed getting fucking killed by that.
There it is.
Oh, my. Oh, pass kids. It back and forth. How's is your butthole puckered up, but good?
Fuck.
Yeah, it is.
Yep, that's what I live for right there.
You know, green apple-flavored lube. Pucker you right up.
Yeah, and bacon lube.
Or you could just shove sour balls up your asshole.
Okay, this isn't South Park.
No, that was actually,
Is that South Park?
No, that was Mr. Pickles.
I got that.
Oh,
I got that somehow. Holy shit.
Dude.
Must have just touched you with that rocket at the last
You saw
second.
That episode of Mr. Pickles where the fucking dude's, like, scrapping metal and just shoving sour... His fucking face caving in just fucking does me in every single fucking time.
I love how brutal Mr. Pickles is. I really can't get over it.
It's literally perfect. Like,
my anus is bleeding.
That was a headshot, too.
The back of my skull is bleeding. Like, dude.
Beer roll!
For my butt, and you just have horrible aim, or are you drunk? Like, damn. Skull fucked me in the back of the head. Gonna make me lick the white slime off of Revenant shit next? This is
nope.
Just called for.
It.
Mm-mm-mm.
Yo, Biff G's back. Oh, you fucking asshole. Oh, kill it. Oh, thank you, you got him.
I killed it with shotguns.
I'll let you out, Beast. I got a double kill. He's out.
Is Bulldog in this party?
I think so.
He was.
He, like, it's hard to get a word in edgewise.
Oh, I just watched someone commit suicide after getting mega.
Just to fall off the fucking map.
That's an interesting piece of music. When you're gonna lay that down on a track? Like, I make doom porn. We could make that.
Alright.
Make me some doom porno music.
No! Oh. Son of a bitch!
Oh, we got it. You still, just, though.
You just couldn't be a dildo. You just had to be a dildo.
Oh, I cannot peg you there. Oh, good game. Good game.
I prefer the term dildo-n't.
Have you guys heard of the fucking...
I know it's actually pronounced dill. Oh!
Have you guys seen this fucking urinary tract dildo?
What?
Like, it's a dildo for your pee hole. Goes up your shaft.
Oh, no.
Yeah, like, fuck that. I've had a catheter. No. That's not pleasant at all. Like, who wants that to happen?
Is it my old coworker? He used to work at a porn shop in the Gaborhood in Philadelphia.
The Gaborhood?
They had things that you could, like... I'm not kidding. They had things you could, like, gauge your... They had things you could gauge your pee hole with. It was scary.
Oh, like piercings?
Not piercings. Stuff you actually, like, shove down your pee hole to gauge the size of your pee hole.
Oh, I have always wanted to split my dick down the middle like a banana split and be able to fuck
not even
bitch
not
in
even
both
split,
holes
just
at the same time.
Tenors.
Not even split it, just
not even split
bigger.
Oh. Why? I don't understand.
Because Gaborhood, bruh.
I'm pretty sheltered, I guess. Like, when I meet Emmy and she tells me, like, stuff that 19-year-old people nowadays, they've been exposed to the internet, like, their whole lives. You guys all had smartphones and shit. Never had ever had a wanted for porn. Like, you always had it, right? So, like...
No.
Well, most people did, like, that are 19, they had a cell phone most of their, like, functioning brain life. I didn't have a smartphone until, like, 5 years ago, and I'm 30. At 37. At 30, I had a smartphone. And at like, 20 or something, I had a cell phone, and I didn't like it. I got rid of it, because all that really would happen is people would call you and ask for rides, because you're, like, the only motherfucker with a cell phone in a car. They just know they can call you all the time. So you get rid of that thing real quick. And you could play Snakebite on it. Does anyone even know what Snakebite is?
Yeah.
Okay. It was bad. And, like, porn? Find wherever my stepfather hid is only two penthouses. And, like, where are these things? And, like, people were hard up, dude. And religious people, where there was no porn in the house. And, like, the dad, he's fucking the daughter and the mom. And then the one boy, he don't get nothing, and he's not even allowed to have porn. That's the way these religious people roll. And then the poor motherfucker with no porn, what has he got? Well, he's got Saturday morning cartoons. He's, like, beating off to Bugs Bunny dressed up as a woman. That's all he's got. He's beating off to Alvin and the Chipmunks and the Chipettes. He grows up years later, and he starts writing fan fiction porn on a forum about Alvin and the Chipmunks, Chipettes, and Alvin's dripping monkhood and shit.
So that's probably where the My Little Pony craze started from.
Yes, dude. Yes, and like Christ. Furries and shit.
That's just sad. That's sad as shit, dude.
Yeah, I know. And you know how I figured that out? Like, I mean, I learned a bunch about neurology and biology and psychology and intelligence and that sort of thing. Studied people. But then the puzzle piece that fell into my lap... was
get back here, asshole.
This random dude in my party just exclaimed chipmunk buttfuck. Like, instead of holy fucking hell, he's just like chipmunk buttfuck. And so I was like, well, that's gonna be my
threat, because you always want to fuck a chipmunk.
No, because like you see what I do,
sense.
Right? So we're all just trying to get even more random and heinous, right? And so it's just what popped into his head for some reason, or as random as you could get. And then I was like, well, that's...
How did you have that much health?
That's the Google, random Google search of the day. Keep Google on its toes. So I searched it. Third synopsis led me to that forum with Alvin's Grip and Monkhood. Oh. I read about a paragraph before all of us were laughing so hard I couldn't read it.
And anymore. I'm gone.
And then I stopped laughing when I realized there was 9 chapters. And then I realized this was real. He was actually getting off on this. You don't write 9 chapters or something if... Like, not like this. Thought it was, like, somebody just being ridiculous, but it was legit. Bye-bye. Then I was like, oh, shit. Why? Fucking sexual starvation. Why do I love porn so much? Because I wasn't allowed to have it when I was the horniest I've ever been in my whole life. Now that I have it, I will never relinquish it. Next bitch I get, she's going to have to love porno and video games and drugs and not be a drug addict. And not have any kids and not want any and be really, really fucking smart. Or she's got to be one of my army of sixes. She just shut the fuck up. Don't talk with my dick in your mouth. It's rude.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, a bunch of sixes taking care of me and just like giving it up. Like a bunch of them. That's fun shit there. Have you guys done that? Have you had stripper lice?
Nope. Not yet.
No stripper lice, no impetigo, no close calls, fuck a bitch, find out 2 days later she had herpes, but you didn't get nothing.
Oh, I
fucking fuck
like
some prostitutes, some strippers.
Balls. Most of my exes are strippers, so yeah.
Hell yeah.
Dude, not going down that road ever, dude, fucking again.
Yeah, strippers. My one ex-rubber.
Fucking hell. Yo, I want an ex-girlfriend, if you won't even call her that. It was kind of like... cheating on my friend's girl. Well, not me cheating on her, she was cheating on him with me, and yeah, she eventually became a prostitute to make some extra money. I was like, fuck that.
Son of a bitch. Why do I keep running into like your whole entire team? Yeah, it's just like holding hands together.
Human centipede ass to mouth in Doom.
Basically, like, fuck.
You should play Kuroma and Abomination, Damnation, Enters.
Dude, if you play those dudes, you probably won't get a kill. It's horrible.
I can hold my own against one of them for sure. Two of them, almost. And then three of them, I'm mangled. Four of them, I'm doing the headlights. I'm like, ooh, what do I do? I'm just gonna shit my pants and let this train run over me. But I don't, I still fight, but like... I've had it happen
before. I was so close to fucking glory kill that asshole. There we go.
No.
Yeah, you ain't catching me. I'm the gingerbread man, you fucking asshole.
Should've backed off. Got greedy.
God damn. I'm 14 and 2, so I'm not too mad.
No, I
hate
fun
that
with
hell
game.
Shot.
Almost no matter
so
what.
So much, dude. That's ridiculous. I hate it when they shoot the fucking Neiman with a Hellshot secondary. Because for like the Mancubus, the Baron, it doesn't do shit. Like the Prowler, anything that has a little bit of health, like, you're fucked.
Guy up high just got hit for 73. I don't know if that helps any.
I'm getting the fuck out of that. Fuck y'all.
Whenever I run into one of you, it's like a clusterfuck of all of them. Which wouldn't
there
be bad.
If... Tony Lara.
Oh my god. Fuck out of here, faggot. Never even heard of you.
Oh.
Here we go.
I've been playing this game long enough to know who the fuck's actually good in this game. Too late. That's what. Ah. Damn it!
Down, Jewel.
Alright, they're gonna sneak over here? Nope, I'm gonna have to go to them. I'll get back. Oh. Son of a bitch. That was good.
Did you see it?
What?
Oh man, I was in a bad spot.
I knew Demon Ruin's gonna be over there too, fuck.
Summon.
Oh, tits.
God, our fucking teammates are retarded.
Got the guy above you.
That was me.
It's coming from that booty hole.
There's all, they're everywhere. Like, that was like a bad case of scabies.
Bullshit! Oh my god.
There we
go. Fuck you, Curtain.
Sorry.
Fuck you. I fucking hit the demon ruin too. That's such shit.
Oh well, at least hit it.
And that motherfucker fell off the goddamn map with it too. Fucking retards.
Now
dude.
You guys killed
I hate the fucking kids on our team.
Him. Yeah, we killed them. He was out in the open with a tank. There's nothing to do. Everybody was there. I'm surprised you didn't die faster, honestly.
Yeah, I just wanted to get to fuck with you.
Fucking goddamn gut. Fucking. This.
Sandwich.
There we go.
Just took her mouth stuff back here.
One of you butt raped me and the other one cauterized the wound.
No, it's more like an Eiffel Tower, but where we have you like spinning like rotisserie between everybody.
Man, you guys are all so much more advanced with your porn than me.
Tits.
Fuck!
That's at least when everyone's porn is revealed, I'll have the most epic views of porn. Even though you guys know way more about porn than I do.
Nah, not really.
Not really.
I don't really watch that much porn.
Dude, everything you guys are talking about, I'm clueless. I feel like I'm culturally illiterate.
Oh, you know what an Eiffel Tower is?
Nope. Or rotisserie.
Oh, when you hit it from, when you have two people,
big roast.
One hits it from the front, one hits it from behind, like... He's on all fours, and then you're, like, high-fiving each other, and you're facing each other. Eiffel Tower. And then...
Huh?
Basically, she's got dick in the mouth, and dick from behind, and then spin.
Big roast.
Oh, that's fucking really inventive. That's really fucking amazing.
And the song, by Dead or Alive...
17. Jesus.
You spin
fuck,
my head right round.
Unreal with 14 assists. That's fucking good.
Oh, did we lose someone? No.
It's cool. You don't want back in? No, you can play with us. I'll back out. I can share it with you if you're just in my squad. Then you get to use it too. So we'll just, like... Okay, or we could do it like we were talking about, Tuna. We could do one of us. We could have two parties of two if we wanted. No, okay, next time that happens, we'll just invite the person who doesn't have the maps to one of our squads.
Yeah.
And that way we continue. Help me, co-pilot. Help me, co-pilot. You're my only hope. Obi-Wan Kenobi. Should we... If we see a bunch of noobs join, should we try to balance the teams a little bit?
All the Vortex rifles.
See this? You see this little picture right there of the map, right?
Yeah.
You guys know...
Yeah.
You guys know the right timing and everything. Run out there right to the middle, dump your grenade and your mortar into the doorway.
Actually, no, I don't
right.
go to that spot.
I've gotten a double kill. First strike or whatever, first blood.
I go out right out there to the... behind chainsaw. You just dump mortars into that motherfucker.
You take it wide.
You have a straighter shot. Yeah, you have a straighter shot, and
so
you don't really expect to go out there, and if you get hit, there's a health pack.
If they're quick, and they spawn almost immediately, and so do you, you have to run, like, directly for the middle, or you aren't going to make it, unless you got teleport grenade. If you got teleport grenade, you could go right over there immediately, teleport right to them, and drop on them immediately, and they're going to be looking across the bridge, and you're going to drop from above them. That's what Karoma and them do, that map. I like to go for the double. If there's two people rushing out that doorway when I get there, I hit them with the mortar and the frag grenade. Double kill right off the rip. It's epic. And then I'm lined up right there to vortex rifle up the hallway to catch the whoever's late. Do you guys notice that, this is the way it is for me, more of the time I spawn on the side of the map where I'd go across that bridge than I do up behind where haste spawns? You know what I'm talking about in this map?
Yeah, we're, mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah,
so
that's where I usually am at.
Yeah, so I go right. I go right when I'm up top. And I go right when I'm down low.
Alright.
See, if we just know where we go, like where we're gonna go, and you say we're gonna follow this person. That'll help right off in the very beginning to just start rolling over.
Yo, I usually always head right up to where haste spawns or where the 50 armor's at. I'm usually hanging around
I
right by there.
I patrol the map. I just stand the outside of it.
Go counterclockwise. I never stop moving, and I do a lot of random shit in that map. And it all depends on what is closest to wherever the fight ended, basically.
Yeah, hold on. I'll be right back.
I think we need to restart this search too. It's fucked up. Oh yeah. Shit, I already forgot what he told me. Son of a bitch bastard. Mm. Oh, beautiful. I almost forgot. I do have shit to do today. God, it's been a long week. Long past 2 weeks. Really, it's been a fucking long couple of months. So, my mom asked me to start looking for a house and land because she's worried about the American dollar devaluing. And she knows she's going to have to retire in America. And so, I'm going to have to take care of her like I took care of her mother. And she told me to start looking for a house before she knew if she could actually go ahead and buy one. So, she had me looking for a month just to finally talk to the loan officer and find out she couldn't do it until the spring. It made more sense to do it in the spring anyway, because she lives in Ecuador and she doesn't want to live here in the winter, basically. But anyway, she doesn't want to move right in. She was like, I'll start it now and my son will move in and I'll move in 6 months or whatever. And she'll be out of the country most of the time anyway until she can't go anywhere, and then I'll be taking care of her, and it'll suck. But she's all right. She's smart artist. But at any rate, so I did that.
Too bad.
I did that like every day because this is a seller's market in this area, the area I'm trying to land in, and it's hard to find the unicorn. Like the unicorn hits the market that day, somebody goes and buys it. There's people just waiting to scoop up the unicorns. So you have to get the MLS listing early in the morning, right away, and as soon as you see one, you gotta immediately go look at it that day and then buy it.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep. It has to happen that way these days. I cannot tell you how many... Go ahead. I'll stop. Yeah, so I'm hooking you up with what I figured out. I solved this puzzle. I actually figured out a lot more than that, too. And now I've added it to my repertoire for my LLC consulting. Not only do I do business consulting with permaculture design philosophy, also how to house hunt. Like, a realtor is not allowed to steer you. They're not allowed to say, nah, you don't want to live in that neighborhood. Trust me, you don't want to live in that neighborhood. They can't say that. But me, I can. And I can be like, no, here's the crime stats. We're going to set it back as far as we can go. We're going to see what type of crime happens here. We're going to see where the crime stops. Then we're going to get on Google Maps, and we're going to look at the buildings where the crime is, the heated point. And you can see where it like thins out and expands from this one point. You can trace it right back to some apartment building where a bunch of poor folk live, or a trailer park in the city anyway, where I live. And like, you get two blocks away from that, and you stop getting hit with crime almost altogether. Because they don't have cars. They're just walking. There's closer targets. And, like, I can't even tell where the kids go, because one direction goes to a park, and there's just vandalism all along that road. It's the kids going from the place to the park, their home to the park. They're fucking up people's cars and shit. And then the other direction is where the older kids go, and they hit a block away in the neighborhood and break into people's basements and shit like that, and, like, cars and shit.
That's shitty.
Yep, so crime here is 80 out of 100, crime index.
Wait, where do you live again?
I live in Ypsilanti. It's like poor Ann Arbor, basically. But there's parts of it that are like just as rich as, maybe more even, than Ann Arbor. I tried to get my mom to buy some land in Superior Township, and we just like build on it slowly. Because I swear, if we just decided to sell that fucking land in like a year, we'd make 50, 60 grand probably. Or more. Because it's just so ridiculous. Shit is disappearing. You know what's fucked up, too? I moved here because out of all the places I researched, this place was the closest to that I could afford to live at, that was also close to being like all sustainable and lots of people who are trying to change and do things like that. And make jobs, and you got weed and shit. Cops aren't in your fucking shit too much in certain towns. Like, then you got all the schools, you got all the fresh water, you're in the center of a tectonic plate, so you don't really have to worry about an earthquake. The winters are typically pretty mild in southern Michigan. Like, sometimes you get a big storm, but it's a lot of that snow and then melt. Like, only like 1 month that's really fucking cold.
You haven't been in Michigan long, have you?
Well, I've been here for 3 years, and that's the way it's been all the time. But admittedly, I don't go outside very much. I don't have to, especially in the winter. I just like, fuck it, I ain't going outside. And like in this city, there's a delivery service that'll just go pick up anything from any restaurant you want.
You're such a dick.
I know. I'm fat kid, straight fat kid these days. I know you're not talking to me. I'm just making you part of the show.
I hate that. I'm running for fucking Demon Ruin. And all of a sudden, over my shoulder, here comes a little teleporter action.
Sorry.
You're stealing my assist!
There goes all my fucking hopes and dreams. Wow.
There's always the next.
Well, that's why I'm saving BFG. I'm just running around trying not to die.
Bye bye, kitty. Spicy ball.
I'm not good.
Huh. Even go away. I'm gonna use my BFG.
Still alive somehow.
Be effective. One kid?
Huh?
One kid? Ooh! I record that.
Cortana, give me a blowjob. lick my ones and zeros. When did we get that? That's what I want right there. Yep. Pretty life like dolls, but nah, that just don't seem right. Like, I'm only kidding about all that necrophilia shit. Come on now. That's just fucking That's just strange right there. But when they start making Borgs that are fucking straight up sex therapy Borgs, it's gonna be epic.
Oh, come on. Am I gonna hit?
To hurry the fuck up with that shit. I'll buy like 5 of them at least. Fucking hopefully they got replaceable vaginas because I'm gonna wear them shits out. Who's with me?
At least you're gonna be one of their number one customers.
Shit, I'll probably be an investor. Probably sell the damn things to pay for my habit.
I'm just fucking these kids up this game. Holy shit, this is like, a really good one.
You watch. 20 years from now, won't be people's cars that people be like, look at my spinners and shit, look at my paint job and shit. Be like, look at my fuck robot. Look at this fucking thing.
Look at my fuck
look
robot.
Look at how well this thing fucks me.
Yeah, dude, look at the gyration on this fucker. Like, look at it.
Look at this fucking thing. You see what I did there?
Oh, yes.
Look at this fucking thing.
It is, because, I mean, you can't even pull it out without doing it. So, Ivory Tower. There's a Sid and Alex old Saturday Night Live where this dude calls up his buddy. It was his birthday. I sent you a present. Oh, what is it? That's great. Thank you. What is it? Oh, you're just going to have to wait and find out.
BFG's in the middle.
Can I fuck it? I don't think so.
Yeah, BFG. Someone get demon.
Does it have individual pots I can fuck? No.
I mean, anything's a flashlight if you're brave enough.
Does it have individual pots that my Amy can fuck me with? I wouldn't want to. God damn, dude, it's a fucking toaster already.
Oh, so
it does. We can fuck it. Matter of fact, two people can fuck it at the same time. Want to come over and fuck my toaster? So just replace that, like, 1990s with fuck robots, and you've got, like, 20 years from now, that's what's gonna happen. Yeah, I'm a futurist. Like, I'm like Ray Kurzweil here. I'd be predicting technology trends. Next thing that's in will be cornrow. That'll be, like, the next pimp thing. Cornrow vagina hair made with real human hair on your fuckbot.
God.
Dreadlocks.
Get that ever. I mean,
pretty soon they're going to be able to start making like meat products without the animal.
They can already in vitro meat.
Well, I mean, like mass quantity and produce that shit, you know, to feed like a city.
Yeah, actually they can. There's a good TED talk. There's a good TED talk about it. Yeah, they already do it. They were like, the hardest part was figuring out how to get it to have the right amount of fat so it didn't just, because like with no fat, it's like too solid meat. It's like too chewy or too tough, right? So they had to mix the right amount of fat in there. And then they showed a cost comparison and like a setup and doing it at your home and like, you know, no water really. Well, yeah, you can grow algae and then you can feed it algae. And then in your refrigerator, you can have the shit growing, like petri dishes of hamburgers growing. And you could have turkey, you could have chicken, you could have anything you want, really. And just for some stem cells. So they would take one cow and they make that one cow into like a bajillion fucking cows. Hamburgers. It's even better than my mad scientist idea, which was to gene splice a whale and a cow, then have a whale cow. Just fucking big fat shit out in the harbor.
That's a whale of a cow.
Oh.
Or is that a cow of a whale?
But and like, then you just that's, get like, the meat from the whale.
Yeah, and like this is even better because that's you just grow. You like that? I got more.
Kind
got
of
more.
Ingenious, but at the same time, I like the petri dish idea better because. You
right,
know.
Like
how about
one,
we splice
we can't
the genes of a pig and an elephant?
Right? Did you guys hear that?
They have many elephants.
They spliced a spider into a goat. And made the goat milk produce spider silk.
So they can make it into, like, bulletproof vests and shit?
No,
right,
they made it into spider goat, like Spider-Man. Spider
right.
Goat,
no, they took
this. Does whatever well,
took
a spider
this.
Goat does.
They took the silk out of the milk.
Yeah, they get a lot more of it.
Call me Young Yeezy. And then
Yeezy baby.
And then they took that silk and made it into, fucking bulletproof vests and shit.
Right? Yeah, it's fucking amazing. I love it. I do. And I'm not for GMO foods that much.
Some
of them are okay. Like, I would bet money that some of them are pretty safe. And it's like you get right down to it, particle for particle, and like what it is when you put it in your body. It doesn't do anything harmful to you. But modern agriculture is harmful. And these corporations like Monsanto that are perpetuating this bullshit, those motherfuckers don't deserve our money. And they're fucking assholes. Like, I've watched a lot of food documentaries. These people are fucking gangsters. They really are. They're worse than any mafia ever. You better be thankful if you're dealing with the mafia. Like, these people are fucking such pieces of shit. All these big corporations, really. All of them. Fucking think they're winning. Really, they're just destroying everything. They're idiots.
I'm still against engineering.
They see two steps ahead, and I see, like, 50. To me, they are children, puppies pissing on the floor, blindfolded children running with scissors. They don't know how to think at all. They're brainwashed. Individualism and ego and sports-driven mentality, and I got the biggest dick, and I'm gonna win, and it's economic game, and like my sports car makes me really, really happy, which it does, but like, doesn't mean that you're better than other people, really. Like, just means you chose to do something different. But at the same time, these rich business people think they're winning, and then after a while, it's just rich people buying the brilliant. They don't even have to be smart. You know, like Donald Trump, he's not running businesses successfully himself. He's hiring people who are much smarter than him to tell him what to do so he doesn't fuck it up. You know, after he fucked up the first one, he was like, damn, I'm a fucking idiot, so I better hire somebody. I got all this money. That's exactly what goes on.
Yo, guys, come over to BFG. I'm camping it right now.
Smart kids right out of college. Fucking pirated.
I'm coming.
Oh, I don't even have to think.
But, that's the reason why I would want Trump in office, is because he would hire people to do his fucking job, basically.
Yeah, no, I see that too, and I don't hate everything about Trump. Like, me and Trump have some stuff in common too. I'm like the Donald Trump of Bill Nye the Science guys who gets fucking high and still fucks hookers and blow, gets high on Charlie Sheen. But I am like him too, like total absolute confidence. I don't want to make America great again. I want to make the world great, period. I don't want to do anything just for America. I'm not patriotic.
Well, if you want to make the world great again, you could just,
America's already pretty good.
I'm universal. Some people have a 10-year plan. I have a 10,000-year plan. It isn't mine. It's actually, I made it from talking to you guys. Well, years and years of talking to you guys. People like you. Video gamers. I used Xbox Live as a think tank resource. And I kept playing off my geopolitical ideas on people. And they'd be like, well, you can't do this because of that. And I'll be like, oh, shit, you're right. Well, I better find a fix for that. Keep on finding fixes for it. So together, figured out a lot of shit about how to fix our world. And let me tell you, nobody has nailed it. Like, I've heard a little piece here and there, like someone's got a piece of the puzzle, and I bet you if I could talk to somebody like Noam Chomsky and like just sit there and have a 3-4 hour conversation, that he probably has thought all this shit already. Like, I'm not the only one. It's impossible. It's too logical not for someone else to think of it. And I mean, there are
one in the crow's nest
doing some of it, but have you guys seen the newest Michael Moore movie?
No, I haven't.
You can watch it for free on F Movies. Run ad blocker before going to F Movies. But yeah, watch a lot of stuff for free. And I think it's the best one. Very little opinions. He just goes to a bunch of countries that do something better than how America does it, and he's just like, I'm stealing that idea, bringing it back. And
please don't tell me they have BFG.
Damn.
Please don't tell me they have BFG. Thank God.
We got BFG now.
That scared the shit out of me. That was a team effort.
And it's weird because, like, in all these countries, they're doing something that's fucking, like, a bunch of shit that's stupid, bullshit, and corrupting.
What the fuck?
I think we played tag, and, like, you thought one was there, and he disappeared, and then I popped up with full health, and you thought that I was still the guy that was hurt.
No, I put up balls of death, and the balls of death, like, went straight through him. I'm not sure if he's lagging or what, but that's instant death, dude.
There's nothing that does more damage than that ball of fucking death. The ball of death is fucking lethal no matter what.
You're stealing my assist!
Motherfucker. Fuck you. Fuck you. Not.
Like, is that joking around? Can that be misconstrued as like running my mouth to somebody and then they get all mad at me? Does that happen?
About what?
I just don't know how people take me half the time. Like, making jokes like that, just fucking around, do people sometimes think you're serious and then they're all pissed off at you?
He's got 10 health. There you go.
Stealing, taking my assist?
Yeah, like, someone might misconstrue that as, like, making fun of someone when you're just fucking around or something and then they get mad at you. Not saying you did, I'm not very good with some aspects of social interaction. And I'm a fucking nerd.
My assist. Right. I want all the fucking assists. Give me them. Fuck, their whole entire team. Their whole entire team is just like, hi guys.
I like
all three of them, so that's three assists, motherfuckers.
I celebrate assists.
I don't. I fucking hate assists. Assist just means I didn't do my job correctly.
Triple assist. Over assist. Assist of Ninjaro. Kiltacular, I don't know. Systacular, it doesn't, you know, I just skip it. Like, fuck it. I got two, the next one.
The lava.
Oh, Demon Crow. I'm sorry, there hasn't been anybody talking to me in my chat for a while. I notice you now. I'll look more often. Yeah, the future is now. It's unfolding constantly. Emergent phenomena, increasing complexity. Every new factor or structure is so many new possibilities.
What he said.
Yeah, what's up, Triton Reaper?
Future is now.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, it's all there is the future happening at every moment. There is no present. There is no past. There was, but it's gone. Somewhere back in space, bits and pieces. Part of other fields. Particles traded back to the Higgs field as you pass through all that. You guys know that all matter and energy is really more like photons from a flashlight. Like the whole Earth, all of us, every particle being fired across space, moving.
Yeah.
They don't even know what the fucking high kappa is.
Right. No, I don't. I actually don't study math. History of
high
math.
High kappa is a modified 1911.
Yeah, you see a 60-degree easement. It's gonna be a problem. We actually lied on our resume. We know nothing about construction. No, nobody knows that movie either. See, all my movie references are these either really obscure or old. Like 80s movies. Do you guys know 80s movies, right? Like, you still watched them? Because they're awesome?
Not really.
Like, the 80s sucked. 80s music sucked. Their style sucked. But their movies were great. They hired actors that could fucking act, and like nobody was pirating. They went to the movie theaters. It was like massive fucking business, right? Shit was primo. And yeah, it isn't quite as pretty, like perfect special effects we have now and that sort of thing, but it was way better acting, way better quality, like in other ways. Felt more authentic. Make any sense? Can you turn me down?
Yeah, I just turned it off.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you.
It was closer to
FIFA Revolution. I'm totally down with that. Oh yeah, we got all sitting here. Where's Infector? I don't know. He played earlier. Like, yeah, I'm down with that. I am. Porno intended.
Exactly. We gotta cut down on chafing. Can't have the revolution chafing them, can we?
Nah, no, dude.
No,
definitely. What was it? I'm gonna have to leave in a little bit because I gotta go get my fucking shit checked out by the doctor.
Yeah, I have to go to the doctor's appointment also. First blood. And I hope everything's all right, guy.
I was gonna have to go get my nut sack checked or something.
Yeah, I'm certain I got a second hernia, which sucks dick.
What is going to happen if you don't go to the doctor? Tell me that.
I can feel like my left nut, right nut, starting to hurt a little bit and get a little bit swollen. So either I need to jerk it more, or I have ball cancer, I'm pregnant, or it's a hernia.
If you're pregnant,
for all the above.
Dude, if you're pregnant, you're going to inherit Walt Disney's fortune.
Fuck out of here. Ow.
He put it in his will, supposedly, that the first man that gives birth to a child inherits everything.
Oh, I'm stuck at sniping.
This is hearsay. Walt. Yeah, I mean, Walt Nut Disney. You'll be the new Walt Nut. Maybe you'll only have one nut. You'll be a one nut wonder, but you'll be so rich it won't matter. You'll pay for like five girls.
That's how you fucking shoot that thing. That's how you shoot the pentagram on its forehead.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's a trap. Fucking beautiful. I love it. I wish there was more traps.
Yeah. Oh, just fucking miss.
I guess you can make a snap map and put all the traps in it you want.
Yo, quad image is back.
Okay, cool, I'm coming.
God damn.
Got it.
That kid would not die. Don't question me. I may have used 3 shots.
It's all about the right question.
Oh. Oh. That, never mind. I'm fucking stupid. We're not gonna talk about it. I'm just gonna keep running and shooting people with a shotgun. I never had BFG. BFG never existed. Never happened. Never happened.
Well, I mean,
I think a clone with BFG. Don't worry about it.
I would say that pretty proudly. That you've never had a big fucking gun.
I mean, I have a 10 gauge underneath my bed. And an AR-15 and a Glock. And my next pickup's a 1911.
Yeah.
Love those.
Is this a 4v2? Is it also 4v1 because one dude's AFK?
I mean, I read another law in Michigan that if you are 12 years old and you don't have any felonies, that you're allowed to have a concealed pistol permit.
No. You have to be 21.
Oh, but 21, no felonies, concealed pistol permit. I'm going to have to get me one. I'm going to get me two...
Or do you, concealed carry?
Two deagles. That's
what I'll do. Spicy Bull's heading over by the haste.
Good luck in your hand on a deagle, and they're kind of shit, too.
USP tactical 45s, actually.
USP. I'd just pick up a Glock for that kind of price. Glocks are more accurate, they're better made and more reliable.
Can I get a Glock that also, and just replace the trigger pretty cheap to get one of the triggers that's on the USP tactical 45?
You would have to talk to like a gunsmith. I'm pretty sure like wherever you purchase the pistol, you might be able to find that out. Spinners? Oh hell yeah, dude.
Okay, if I can get
you have to get the spinner bullets though. You gotta get the spinner bullets. Those things are sick. You shoot the bullet, and it fucking spins. Yeah, it's awesome. I just sniped him with the demon. Sniped.
So you guys ain't seen Where the Buffalo Roams? Have you?
Nope.
I have. Yes.
Bill Murray.
Yep. Isn't it about epic. Dr. Gonzo? Or
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
So check this out. Definitely. I watched Fear and Loathing several times. One of my favorite movies, right? I stumbled on that one years later, and then realized the truth, and had to go back and watch Fear and Loathing again.
Yeah, cause isn't because Dr. Gonzo the lawyer?
Yeah, like in Fear and Loathing, it isn't really that clear that he's actually an alter ego, right? And he's talking to himself and yelling at himself, you're a pig fucker and all this shit. And he's the one, like fucking the Jesus freak Barbara Streisand bitch in the hotel. And, like, who's yelling at who in the bathtub of Ahab? Like, I had to go back and watch the whole thing and be like, oh my god, it's so much better than I thought it was. I love those movies. I wish I could go party with Hunter S. Thompson.
You son of a bitch! You
Son of a bitch! Like, you don't have enough kills? Come on now.
I thought you were doing Raoul Duke there. Pick fucker.
Alright, where's this Demon Crow dude at, though?
He's just, sorry, like, running around trying to snipe, getting his shit pushed in by my shotguns.
Look what God did to his man! No, I mean,
like, he's
man.
Literally, like, AFK. At least every time I see him, he's just sitting in the corner.
There was a couple times where he was, like, pointing a gun at me, and I was like, oh, what do you think you're doing? Maybe he had to go do something to put his controller down. I just don't want ever, yeah, he's like bad. Pointing straight up right now.
Maybe it's somebody's mom who's never played video games.
No, I'm pretty sure they both left. It just hasn't disconnected them yet.
Really?
That'd make most sense to me. Oh yeah, it does that all the time. Whenever you leave a lobby, you don't leave a lobby.
You're just getting killed. Yeah, your ghost is just getting killed. You're the ghost in the machine.
You will get fucked up over and over and over until the game finally decides to disconnect you out of the game.
Yeah, what I do is I back all the way out of multiplayer, because if not, I can't even invite people because the game thinks I'm still in the game. But you back out of just one step back and then right back in, and you're good. Probably rips your character out of there quicker too. But I've joined games. I come into the game, I kill somebody.
There goes one.
And I just get in there, I kill somebody, and I get a comeback kill. I'm the demon.
Yeah, Demon Pro, that's another team.
Oh, okay.
Not you, don't worry.
I was like, get your voodoo off of me.
You are such a... you're using the fucking BFG to look through walls to find him.
Oh yeah, that's fucking sweet, I forgot about that for one game.
You dig. I wish I could kill teammates. That'd have so much more fun. Can you imagine?
Soon we'll fight each other free for all.
I just mean, like, killing your own teammates with a BFG and then getting yourself kicked because you killed too many teammates. Lol.
Oh, you...
I'm guessing this guy's AFK and he puts controller so it didn't
one,
make him look straight
two.
Up. The other one, he left. Yeah. He definitely left. This
what
one,
a
he's just.
Douche.
Oh. Weird.
Well,
he was using a sniper.
We'll learn the spawns this way.
True.
Sort of? Kind of?
Yeah.
Not really. I mean. And two's.
Yeah, we got to pay attention where he is when we kill him, and then pay attention where we are at that point.
Yo,
he'll spawn us far away.
His backside.
1 minute remaining. Backside. What's backside? which is up and down. Call he's cracking up.
I stole the BFG from you.
Yeah, that'll happen.
He went to go kill him. I stole the BFG. I found him. He's in mid. Demon room spawned. Ow.
That's when you put it down and shoot him.
Yeah, but did you notice I put it down? I hit him with a shotgun
right
first.
Back up.
Yeah, hit him with a shotgun first. I went to go switch to the other shotgun just to pop off around. Yeah, that didn't work out too well.
Four, three. This shit is bullshit.
He's by Mega.
Man, I'm surprised we didn't find fucking Jesus, because that was like Easter egg hunting. They fucking hid the eggs good.
I love it when there's only like two people.
I don't. I want there to be six.
My kitty.
I'm just kidding.
So.
Oh, Triton, you fucker, you screwing me.
Ow, my fucking shit.
I'm way too high to be fucked with in the mind.
Puppy.
Yeah, I was in the wrong place at the wrong time a lot. Alright, nope. Sorry, Demon Crow. You're a punk bitch. Matter of fact. Let's just take care of this fucker.
Yeah, I was in the wrong place.
Is everyone still here? We good? Is yep. Infector coming? Oh, that's it right there, actually. Unfortunately. Wait a minute. This is my reminder. Hold on a second. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry.
Really?
Yeah, okay, so that was basically everybody's got to go to appointments. Shit going off. I'm going to play one more because I don't want that to be my last one. That was fucking ridiculous. It'll leave a bad taste in my mouth. Infector Z is
yeah, I know who it is.
Yeah. Saw, dude. Spow.
Dude, saw.
Are you shilling me? Up.
Thank you. Come again. Please and thank you.
Saw,
dude.
What is saw? Is it only me that's this ignorant about all of these things?
It's like the stoner would just say, "What's up, dude?"
Okay. It's like can't quite make out the P because that's just too much effort. Dude. I see. Yeah, I've been there before. Damn. Let's do that. Fuck you, game. See, I think when it's like that and it won't start up, it thinks we're ghosts in the machine still. We're still in that game with Jesus playing fucking Easter egg hunt. You gotta, like, trick it. Do it twice. Daddy Foam 6969 says, "Wanna suck on my tongue while I give you some dick?" And then Tuna, what is that? Is that a dildo or a lightsaber? Or is it a lightsaber dildo?
Gay bombs.
Oh, that's what it is. Oh, yeah. That's what it is. Gay bombs. Interesting. Like, that's... Okay, so what do I have to do to have
drop
gay bombs on people? What else is there?
All sorts of shit.
Can you turn me down? Dance at your wedding.
Gosh, I'm spamming the fuck out of you with Illuminati. Illuminati.
That's convenient, because I made a tinfoil hat for my dick today.